It's Buck, Dee, and Shondeen, a show to be forever, a show that'll do whatever our viewers desire. It's Buck, Dee, and Shondeen, a show of perfection, an object of affection to quench our viewers' fire. Completely free from infection, to be used at our viewers' discretion, waiting only for your direction. It's Buck, Dee, and Shondeen.
I'm tired. There ain't nothing to do. We can't go nowhere. This Rona ain't it, man. Oh, hold on, girl. Let me play you this new album I just bought.
Yeah, it's going double balled up. Aluminum Foil and Cover Your Mouth Productions proudly presents 2020 COVID Hits. The quintessential sounds that got us through the Ronas. Robert Isley and the Isley Brothers. Patti LaBuck and Michael McDonald. Damn, I should have thought of this shit. The sultry sounds of Buck Rawls and much, much more.
You'll never find.
Yes, you get 511 of the only coronavirus ballads and hits ever recorded.
The ones who protect you.
Not sold in any store, bodega, swap meet, flea market, trunk, or outlet. This exclusive internet offer is available only here and only now.
Eggshells, if they ain't 6 feet away, told me that I got.
You get Mary J. Buck. The incomparable Buck Pendergrass.
Forget about a quarantine. Ain't no COVID in my place.
Buck 12.
COVID 19. We can't go home cause we can't go outside.
And a soulful Buck Green.
Love the stimulus. Yeah. Something that'll pay off my phone. And I can buy some new knives.
And a gang of more songs that you didn't even know was COVID classics.
COVID got me tripping. And my heart on, so stay your ass home.
Remember, this limited ensemble is not to be streamed on any platform.
Go back to the days that sports was on.
Operators are standing by to take your money. Order now before the sounds of COVID hits get away.
Yes, girl. What is this? That's that COVID hit.
To order your copy of 2020 COVID Hits, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-RONAS. That's 1-800-327-6627. Or rush 4958 plus $80.13 in shipping and handling to COVID Hits. VS Box 6969, Department X, Albuquerque, New Mexico, 87109. Operators are standing by. Call 1-800-RONAS. Satisfaction guaranteed. Call now. Cash App, Venmo, PayPal, WIC vouchers, and food stamps are all accepted.
Baby, you gotta let me borrow this. You gotta get your own. And we're back.
We are back. Y'all have to get the little behind the scenes of what we talk about, because a lot of stuff we can't say on air. Well, when I say we, I mean Shondeen.
Because of my dirty mouth.
We are back. We are back to the Buck D and Shondeen show. Once again, I am not Shondeen.
And I'm definitely not Buck.
What's up, man? How you doing?
I'm good.
I got a birthday coming up.
It's Buck's birthday. Wait till you see his birthday surprises.
I'm about to be 42.
Don't admit that.
Yeah. I'm 42. Yes.
He looks like he's 17. Yes, 42. I've lost weight and everything. I'm over here looking like Big Pun. I'm next to this guy.
So you wanted to talk, let's get right into it. So the governor came through and gave us a little 25%.
She threw us a bone.
How do you feel? 25% so we can go anywhere to eat? That's
I'm really happy. There's this faux restaurant.
Oh, is that where you?
Yes.
So you went from, I look like Big Pun to I want to pig out on faux that quick. You see how you forgot about it?
I know, bro. I'm like, yeah.
That fast. She just went from big, I want to eat faux.
Yeah.
So.
I can't wait to go. I love
it. Is that, okay, look. Not to make this like
a
sexist thing. Is that something that women mainly do? I haven't heard a dude say, you know what, let's go eat some pho. Like my homeboy and be like, let's go eat some pho. And
I'm
like,
you guys never had it.
The only pho we eat is the pho for pho at Wendy's. That was it.
I like that too.
No, what is pho? I'm not even gonna lie to you. What is
it? It's actually pronounced pho. I was hoping you would correct me because I thought you were a pho eater further.
Oh, I eat fur. First, not a problem. I can go get pho for pho first.
Pho.
So what is that? That's like a Vietnamese dish,
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah, noodles, and then they put meat or shrimp or chicken on top.
Oh, yes, yeah.
But it's so good, and it's good for you.
I'll try it. You know what? I stay around the corner from a Vietnamese restaurant. I always say, I'm going to go check it out. But I get afraid because I won't know how to pronounce nothing, and yeah. I don't want to offend anybody and be like pointing at the menu.
Well, they know. They that's why they do it in numbers. They got it in numbers.
So that's where you want to go.
That's where we're going. I'm going to take you for your birthday.
Oh, yeah.
I'm taking you.
We got this on film. Me, I haven't even thought about it. It's just, I've been doing the patio hopping. It hasn't been an issue.
Yeah.
It's like, but like now it's about to be fall. It's about to be winter. Hope these numbers keep going down.
That's what I'm scared of. Are we going to see a second wave?
Wasn't the first wave, Sean. There was no first wave. Like, before y'all get mad, because people take this stuff really seriously. Like,
they do.
Everybody didn't get the Rona, y'all. Sorry to break the news. I believe this stuff was different for different people, like I was saying.
Yeah.
If you're perfectly healthy, you probably had it and didn't know.
Right.
Or if you didn't get it.
Right.
It's just, I believe it's, you know, it's people, and it's sad because, you know, I'm a minority, and they're like, "Oh, it's killing minorities," and because pre-existing conditions.
I want to see how many minorities are actually how many.
Well, I believe it. I believe it because of two things. We're gonna get serious now. Two things, because one, healthcare is almost cussed. It's real bad for minorities. Think about it. Think about Native Americans. Think about Hispanics. Think about Blacks. A lot of us don't even have health insurance in the first place. But then if you do, you probably got bare minimum. So you don't have like the best of anything. Second, this is another thing that I was talking to a friend about. We eat bad. Like soul food is horrible. If you think about Mexican food.
That's why we're getting
it's all of the scraps. Like we take the trash and make it a delicatessen.
Yeah.
And then we wonder, like we're eating pig ears, we're eating cow belly.
Oxtails. Like, that walked in, everybody's eating the pork rinds. You know, the pork rinds.
Oh, yeah. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, who looked at a pig and be like, you know what? If you take the skin off and you fry it, like, who said that?
The pork rinds and chip and guacamole. And
like, let me tell you the worst thing in soul food history. Is a chitlin, man. Do you know what a chitlin is?
What is a chitlin?
Okay, it's first of all, this is how messed up it is. It comes in a 5-pound bucket. And on the bucket, it says chitterling. So we don't want to say all that. We just call it a chitlin.
Okay.
A chitlin is the intestines of a pig.
Oh, okay. And yeah, so, for us, it's the tripa.
Yeah.
The menudo. That's what we have in menudo.
Yeah,
right?
You just take that.
There we go.
You take that, you squeeze out all the and you bleach it and then you cook it. Like, that's horrible. That's bad.
Yeah.
And so,
I won't eat menudo.
See what I'm saying? And then a lot of people get mad and they're like, oh, you're too good to eat your food. It's like, yes, I am. Yeah. That's trash. Yes. Like, that's all the stuff that the meat markets throw in the trash. And
Buck
then,
is so white. Buck is a white.
Yeah. No, it's not that I'm white. It's like, I'm tired of eating it.
Yeah.
Like, come on, man. Like, That's scary. Like I have, so my grandmother passed. She had a quadruple bypass, heart surgery. So she died of heart problems. And that scares me because, so it's like, I don't want to be, if you're going to take me out, let it be by one of your conspiracy theories. I don't want it to be taken out from stuff that I ate.
Alien abduction is highly likely with this guy.
Nah, they'll bring me back. They're like, nah, this ain't the dude. So yeah, I think that is true. But that second wave is like, come on, man. Like, really? Is that what we're doing?
What would you say? Are you going to do anything if they try to force a second wave?
What do you mean? How do you force it?
That when you just mandate everybody to quarantine.
Well, you have to. Look, we survived that first one. The second one won't be bad because it'll be cold outside. Nobody wants to be outside anyway.
Yeah.
So you're good. If we got through the summer during all this, anything else is fine. It's all good. I don't care. I don't. All of that, it don't even bother me no more. So let's all be hermits.
It stays
beautiful. Let's stay in our huts.
It stays pretty sunny throughout up until like November.
Yeah, we're good. So also let everybody know we do have a special guest today.
We do, guys, which is really rare.
Shondeen always calls me like, hey, we got somebody, bring him. I'm like, okay, let's do it.
I know.
So you guys stay tuned, man. We're going to take a little break and we come back. You will see who our special guest is on the Buck D and Shondeen show. Are back. As you can see, we have one more person into the mix. Introduce yourself. Let everybody know who you are.
Well, it's Brittney, bitch.
There we have it. How you doing, Brittney?
I'm doing really good. Thank you for having me.
So I want to let y'all know, so all of this is impromptu. We didn't sit down. We never have a pre-show production or any of that because we want the authenticity, all of that good stuff. So like we were talking about before, Shondeen was saying, we did a show, if you guys already do remember, we did a show about businesses who were surviving during the Rona, during the COVID. So now let's hit the other side of the coin. And do you want to go ahead and preface it, Shondeen?
Yeah,
or do we want to go straight into Brittney, bitch?
Yeah. I was searching on Facebook. You know what I like to do on my Facebook stalking?
Right.
And I came across Brittney's story where they put up a GoFundMe. Her family is let's talk about your famous family with famous Hummingbird. Everybody knows Hummingbird Music Camp. Mm-hmm. It's associated with the APS field trips.
Right.
Where they take the kids for the music camp every year.
Yeah. Hummingbird's, my grandparents founded it. It's been in business for 62 years.
Wow.
Haven't missed a summer since they built it.
Man, you look good to be 62.
She twerked on the way in. That's totally missed it.
So with the interruption in school, as we know, you know, everything's going virtual, it hit you guys pretty hard, right?
Well, you know, camp, the beauty of camp is it's 60 acres in the Hamas Mountains.
Right.
They try to keep it as such untainted, you know. If you to know the Wi-Fi password, you're either a teacher or a teacher's kid,
or your
family. Like, I mean,
you don't get any of that.
No,
right.
But they really try to preserve, you know, the beauty and the simplicity of it. And, you know, it's a camp for children. And you look around when you're out there, and these kids are they're learning and playing music, and they're all at ages like 8, you know, to 21, and it's just the most precious. It's very beautiful. It's very pure, virtuous.
Right.
Know?
It's something that you don't see nowadays, especially with children of that age, because everybody's all about the internet, technology, laptops, and social media and all that other stuff. So is that something that, you know, you guys basically refrain from? Is that what you're saying?
I mean, it's a double-edged sword. So, I mean, you have to stay connected. And just the way everything's going with the, you know, kids today, they're connected.
Right. Yeah,
so
yeah.
I would say there's a little bit of a disconnect because camp's old school. I mean, my grandparents were old school. They're both past it right now. My father and his two sisters are running it. It's the Higgins family. And, you know, it's all in the family.
Right.
They're trying to preserve, you know, how they would do business, how my grandparents would do business, and it's relationships still, and it's not, you know, it's not corporate, there's no sponsorships, it's
organic roots.
Yeah, it is, and that's the beauty in it.
Right.
That's also, you know, kind of the antagonist though too, because the kids are online.
Right.
So, gotcha. There's a bridge there. You know, it's just frustrating. I think this whole COVID thing and the fact that camp's not in business this summer, which is shocking to everybody.
Well, because that makes no sense to me, because the whole thing is social distancing and you guys are outside. Like, what's the issue? You're not sitting in a building. You're not
6 feet away, you know, outside.
Yeah. I think that would have been the best situation, especially for children, because they made school virtual, that we had the, you know, the lockdown or the quarantine. Kids are itching to do something, and then for them not to be able to do that, that's like, that doesn't make sense to me.
It's disappointing. Right. It really is. And they did everything. They tried to follow every guideline that you could. They were going to, you know, and there is buildings. I mean, there's just a bunch of buildings on campus, but, and there was going to be a minimum, you know, there's 9 weeks of camp. It's 9 weeks of music. There's 6 weeks of art and 3 weeks of chess.
Oh, wow.
And I think it ranges anywhere from 100 kids a week. It's Sunday to Sunday. To when I was growing up, it was like 200.
Wow.
And then you've got your staffers, your counselors in training, your counselors, and then your head counselors. And it's just such a sad loss. And if camp, you know,
So when you say it's a loss, like it's completely out of business? Is it not going to be able to recover, or?
Well, that's the thing. The summer keeps the rest of the year going.
You know,
that summer funding. And the rest of the year rents out to APS, different organizations, church groups.
Oh, gotcha,
Come out for retreats, things like that, little small things. And the maintenance alone to keep all the buildings up to date and going, and the energy, the power, water, all that. It's a lot. So not being in business this summer. And it is already, you know, camp's never been for profit. It's been for the kids.
Right.
It's always been about the kids. My grandfather was like, we teach music and we teach children and the subject is music.
Wow.
That was his motto.
Wow.
And that's what they want to keep alive. Wow. And that's why they started this GoFundMe page, because camp can't go away. Like, it has to sustain.
Mm-hmm.
62 years, and my grandmother just passed recently. Like I would do everything in my power to, you know, shake the cage and make some noise and let it be known that, like, we have to keep this alive and we have to preserve it, you know, the beauty of it, the land, I mean, the river runs through it a mile and to the waterfall, Battleship Rock.
Oh, yeah.
You know, 2.5 miles up to Macaulay Hot Springs, Warm Springs. I mean, it's like, epic.
Yeah.
Like, it's
so epic. What we have to do, Shondeen, we have to make sure that we get the link for the GoFundMe so we can have it on the video. So anybody who's watching this, or if you 62 years, it's some people, it's some grown people that's been through this. You guys have gone through
Hummingbird. You know somebody that's been Hummingbird. You've been yourself, your kids have gone. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like 1 degree of separation, right?
Yeah. Wow.
And
wow.
If you're Latino, it's already 4 generations deep right now.
Or if you're Higgins.
So what are you doing in the meantime? What, like, how are you staying busy? Is there...
Camp is trying to do everything it can to... every week they were, like, trying to open... Mm-hmm. We were trying to, can we do it? Can we do it?
Right.
You know, at this point, it's like, there's nothing that can be done except prepare for next year, try to get through.
Right.
And, I mean, maybe work on maybe a virtual presence in case this doesn't evolve.
I don't know how that would work.
It doesn't work. There's something about the connection and small children, and you can't control the kids, and the unique connection when you're learning, and, you know, it's the environment, the camp. The whole, it's an experience.
Yeah, I think that right now, everyone with all the Zoom meetings and that sounds like a nice retreat.
Yeah, exactly.
Post-Rona.
So let's do this. Let's do this, Shondeen. We're going to take a break. Everyone, you do see the link there for the GoFundMe for Hummingbird. Do what you can. Pass it along. Everyone, let's help save a business, because we've always been hearing about, hey, let's support local. Here's a great way to do so. So we're going to take a break, and we come back. Let's get into Brittney the person. Let's do that, Sean.
Yeah, let's get into Brittney, bitch.
We are back. I tell y'all, man, y'all need to be here for these, for the in-between segments. So we're back with Brittney. Yeah. So we got the business out of the way. Let's get a little personal, because we love to have people on the show and be very nosy. So the first thing we were talking about is, what did you do during the quarantine, during this whole summer, that you probably wouldn't have done before? I'll give you an example. So this quarantine, you know, it's the biggest thing I did, and you probably forgot. I got a vasectomy.
Oh, yeah.
I got a vasectomy. You know how bored a man has to be to just be like, you know what? I'm going to just stop the flow. I'm going to just, no more babies. So there's no way, if the Rona wasn't here, that I would, I don't even know. Seriously, I was just sitting working at home. And I was like, you know what? I should just go get a vasectomy, because I don't want to have a Rona baby.
Because he was tired of playing.
I was just like, I don't want to do that. So what about you, Shondeen? What did you do during this whole thing that
I
you
said,
would have normally
Well, they had closed
done?
The gyms. Mm-hmm. So I said, you know what? There's got to be another way. And I found a private pole dancing exercise place downtown, where, and it's like appointment only, and she takes appointments, and I found that.
So it's like one-on-one?
Yeah, it's one-on-one, and I actually posted something to my story with her doing all her crazy acrobatic.
Wow.
It was really beautiful, yeah.
I wonder if I would sign up, how she would feel.
I love it.
No, I'd be like, no, you show me. That's all I would be like, so, no, you show me. You do it again, I can get it. Show me. So what about you, Brittney? What have you done?
Oh, man. The whole COVID thing's been the opposite for me. So when everybody else went on lockdown, mm-hmm. I went to Aspen to go snowboarding because it was my 40th birthday.
Yeah.
There we go.
I that was the day they shut it down. Like, no travel for
so
fun.
You were like, I'm out.
I was like, I planned this for like a month.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
And I left Aspen the day after they shut the whole mountain down.
Oh, wow.
The day before they shut it all down.
So, okay, I'm glad you said this, because everybody's been so in their head and we can't do. I'm glad you said that, because I'm like you. Look, okay, there's a life to be lived. I'm not finna, especially when you're in your 40s, man. Look, when you hit 40, you just be like, hey, you can't tell me not to do something. I'm gonna do it. You find the loopholes, like Shondeen. I don't think you should name the company, because somebody's gonna be like, they shouldn't have been doing anything or whatever.
Yeah, no, well, that, it wasn't it, during that time, no, but it was like right after that time. So it was like right after the shutdown, like where they're starting to slowly, you know, 25%.
Yeah.
So like that. Yeah.
Watch this. Watch this. Brittney's not gonna be expecting this. So did you date during the Rona?
Yeah.
Did you date? Look at her. Did you date? I was just, what I did?
Did you date?
What I did on the break was I looked at her thing. I was like, I don't want to ask. Okay, she got the naked knuckles, so I need to know.
I'm getting divorced.
Hey, that's more reason to party.
Yeah, no.
So have you dated during the Rona?
No, not serious. No, I don't date seriously.
No, dating is never serious.
Yeah, so
dating is. Look,
no.
You're on our show. You're on our show.
I do whatever I want whenever I want.
There's probably a guy whose feelings you hurt. I thought we were dating. No, she's like, no, it's not serious.
No, we friends.
So how was it during the Rona? Like, was it different? Like, does the Rona change everything?
Yeah, I mean, you don't. Yeah, you make Facebook friends. You don't go out. You don't meet at a bar
and drinks
anymore. Now it's like you go to some house you never met, and you're like, oh God, please don't kill me.
Yeah.
See, and look, as men, didn't we say this? As men, we love dating during the Rona, because look, especially, well, I'm saying men, not boys. Men, as in guys who have their own place and all this, because you're like, guess when she has to come?
Right.
My place.
Yeah.
Cause you don't wanna, as a guy, you don't, if we're dating, I'm not gonna be like, oh, let's go on a date, I'll come to your crib. The first thing a woman is gonna think is what? He has nowhere to live, or he lives with his baby mama or something like that.
Yeah, he's trying to run game.
He's trying to move in. So
yeah, they don't like that, yeah.
Look.
Yeah, yeah.
Shondeen must have had a flashback. She's like, wait a minute, no.
I know. I'm trying to post up. Are those your shoes?
Yeah. Hey.
You want a sneak peek.
You did not leave your shoes.
So how was it though? You dated, you went to his house or his crib where you just, were you doing the whole, I got my purse and I'm not, you know how when they sit on the edge and like, all right. Look, if a woman ever comes over to your crib and does this right here, she's ready to leave. Like, no, she's ready to go. So, okay, so you dating, you do. So, what happened? Like, was it just something to do during the Rona?
I mean, I don't know. It was such a weird time. Yeah. You know, but I'm a free spirit and I love connecting with people.
I network
all the time. And, like, I will always just ride the wave of, you know, and I love to, you know, experience.
Look, it's look. You got some dudes right now gonna be like, "What is
her social media?" Yeah.
She wants to ride the second wave, y'all.
Yeah.
Anyway,
even right.
No, because you know what I'm saying. Like we do, we love to do on the show. We talk the business, but then we like to have fun. So, how do you see it? I want you to answer Shondeen's question from the first segment about the second one. You think that's real?
What do you think of that?
Yeah.
You know, it's a double-edged sword. It's like part of me wants to acknowledge the reality that that's a legitimate possibility.
Right.
But I personally can't live in fear. So
right.
I have to like define my boundaries and not let things creep in, because it paralyzes me to a point where I start to get irrational, and then I can't function properly. And I have to live,
yeah.
You know, and I can't function properly otherwise. So
I was like that. I was like, do you remember what the asteroids?
Yes, I was terrified when you were. Oh my God!
I thought that was an asteroid.
She's told everybody. I thought this was just something you told maybe one or two people.
Oh no. No.
The ass.
I was terrified. My dad was like, well, it's time to go. It's my time to go.
See, he's like me. I'm like, what? You can't outrun an asteroid. Like, what are you going to do?
You're like, no.
You can see it coming and be like, well, hey, I had fun.
Right?
Everybody's doing that. I know. And I kept going into this, like, fear. Oh, but, and I knew you were scared too, because you were like, oh,
you were like, what?
Because you whip people up in the fear, you can't do that.
She went to go hide at Hummingbird Camp, and I was so pissed because she didn't invite me.
I did invite you.
And the asteroid was going to come. And she didn't invite me.
I went down there every weekend for like you 2 months. And I didn't invite you.
I was like, she didn't invite me.
Because she wanted to survive, Shondeen. That's why. You probably would have killed her before the asteroid got here.
I was like, the end of the world.
Shopping.
I did.
All right, so we're at the end of the show. Thank you once again, Brittney, for coming.
Thank you for having
being
me.
Open, being candid. She was a little nervous, so we had to relax her a little bit without any type of inhibition.
She wasn't nervous in between the cuts when she was.
I know.
Talking.
Well, yeah, y'all missed the choking part. Look.
See, that was the take. No, follow me under.
You guys know where to find us every Tuesday, 10:30 p.m. at Comcast Channel 26. My name is Buck D.
Shondeen, and follow us on IG. I just got the page.
There we go. Shondeen's got us Instagram going. It's called what? The Buck D and Shondeen Show. Y'all know what it is. Go follow us. Go share this. And also, please give to the Hummingbird GoFundMe as well. We out.
Thank you.